Hello everyone, this is Dr. Kalpana and you're watching my YouTube channel Pharmacy Lessons Made Easy. So far we have discussed many topics of unit operation. One of them was ball mill, then hammer mill. The next to this is fluid energy mill. This will be discussed in the current video. We have already covered what is pharmaceutical engineering, what is unit operation, the size reduction, its definition, other names, need, advantages, other effects, mechanism of size reduction, factors affecting size reduction in terms of nature of raw material, finished product, safety of the whole process overall, and the economy which is associated. Further we have covered the ball mill and hammer mill, the classification of mills, and more specifically the ball mill and hammer mill with special emphasis on its principle, working, uses, advantages and disadvantages or limitation. So for studying those topics you can see my previous videos. They are available on the same YouTube channel, Pharmacy Lessons Made Easy. Right, let's begin with the next topic, that is fluid energy mill. See, like the same way as ball mill, this fluid energy mill is based on both impact and attrition combination. The feed is actually suspended within a high velocity airstream, and the size reduction or milling take place because of high velocity collision between the suspended particles. So if we see the diagram, it appears like this. There's a cylindrical tube, pulverization zone, and from here this is the real actual fluid energy mill. Okay, so basic construction is, it has an elliptical pipe. The height is approximately 2 meter and diameter ranges from 20 to 200 millimeter. The material through which it is made up of is either soft stainless steel or tough ceramics. It has removable contact surfaces. The grinding nozzles vary from 2 to 6 and they may be tangential or opposed to the initial path of flow of the powder. I'll show you the grinding nozzles. These are the grinding nozzles. Okay, they vary from 2 to 6 in number. This is the hopper through which the liquid will enter, the solid particle which are to be reduced in the size will enter, and they were subjected to these nozzles, and after getting the size reduction by combination of impact and attrition, they are subjected to the cyclone separator, and from here they get exited out, right? So from here the air is getting entered continuously. Okay, so this is grinding nozzles 2 to 6 in number. They may be tangential or opposed to the initial flow path of the powder. The compressed air which is coming from the bottom part of it has 600 kilopascal to 1 megapascal pressure, and the inert gas can be used for oxidation prone substances like nitrogen, which will not react with the material which is to be reduced in size. There is a venturi feeder in the path of airflow and the outlet with a classifier or cyclone separator of back filter which allow the escape of air, right? So this was, and this is the actual photograph of fluid energy mill. Now how it works, basically the powder is introduced through the inlet of venturi, the right portion, this one. So the air entering through the grinding nozzle transport the powder in the elliptical or circular path of the mill. This is the bottom part. In the turbulent stream of air, the suspended particles collide with each other and break via impact or attrition, both, right? This turbulent stream of air, the suspended particle will collide with each other and break via impact and attrition both. The smaller particles are carried to the outlet, which is removed by cyclone or filters, and the coarser particle will get recycled in the chamber on account of its own weight remain there until sufficiently reduced. Later, they leave via the sieves, and it has narrow size distribution of particles. That means the difference is very less among the particles, right? So if we see here, the particles being having tangential motion, they will enter like this, okay, and will have this path, okay. During this journey, both impact and attrition will take place, and once they are reduced in size, they will enter this area, and those with the larger size, because of its own gravity, will settle down and again recycle due to this air which is coming down, right? So this is how it happens. Okay, so next thing is working done. Next is the uses. What are the uses of this fluid energy mill? Basically, most of the drugs like antibiotics and vitamins, they are reduced in size by fluid energy mill. Preferably, when there is strict quality control is desirable, then we use this one. Ultra fine grinding can even be achieved, and not only this, the moderately hard materials can also be processed by fluid energy mill. The advantages which are associated with using fluid energy mill is, number one, no moving part or no heat generation take place. It is suitable for thermolabile substances like sulfonamides, vitamins, antibiotics. Because of the expansion of gases under pressure, it produces a cooling effect. So it can be used for thermolabile substances. And there is no chance of contamination of product, as the mill will not be subjected to wear and tear like the case with the ball mill, okay. Next is the disadvantages which are associated with the use of hammer mill are, number one, it is not suitable for milling of soft, tacky and fibrous materials, and second thing is the equipment is quite expensive, particularly the fluid energy source and the dust collection equipment, right? So in the next video, we shall discuss about the energy of comminution or size reduction. There has been three theories which are proposed. One is Rettinger's theory, other is Bond's theory, and Kick's theory. We shall discuss these theories one by one in our upcoming videos. Thank you. Have a nice day. If you like the video, please click on the like button. Do subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.